is a current and output produced is a voltage. Operational amplifiers are not often used as any one of them except voltage amplifiers. This is some simple circuit. This circuit shows that it has a feedback. This is not open circuit, open loop. It is a closed loop. Why is it a closed loop? Have a look at the output terminal. From the output terminal, you have two resistances in series connected. So output voltage will get divided into two parts. One is across one resistance and another across another resistance connected to ground. And the voltage across a resistance which is connected to the ground is given as one of the input. Depending upon which terminal you are connecting this point to, will decide whether it is an inverting or non-inverting amplifier, whether it is a negative feedback or a positive feedback. For example, the potential divider line from the output, if I am connecting back to the input at negative terminal of operational amplifier, it would become a negative feedback. But if the same terminal I am connecting it to positive terminal of input of operational amplifier, it will become a positive feedback. Positive feedback often takes amplifier towards instability. Negative feedback often brings the system towards stability. So, negative feedback is the only feedback that we consider for connections. In amplifiers, we don't have positive feedback. But positive feedback is definitely used for some purpose. And positive feedback, when you use, your amplifiers become oscillators. You must have seen that Weinbridge you use in a feedback circuit and create Weinbridge oscillator. LC feedback you take to create Colpitt or Hartley oscillator. You create different oscillators which produce sound. The oscillators are amplifiers only, but which do not require any input. Output is present without any input, and that input is derived from the output itself. I'll come to this particular part later. Right now, you remember that in operational amplifiers, there are two inputs, plus and minus. When you connect a feedback to minus, it is a negative feedback. When you connect feedback to positive, it is a positive feedback. Let us go next. The same circuit I have drawn in a different form. If you look at, I had drawn a circuit in slightly different form. I will leave it to you to compare that. And this is one example that we have of current amplifiers. Don't worry, I am right now giving you schematics of diagrams and I will be designing those circuits for our typical case. Now have a look at this circuit. This is a current amplifier. In the current amplifier, we are connecting output load in such a manner that load itself is coming in a feedback loop. I will repeat, this type of circuits are not preferred. There could be circuits. The previous slide showed you voltage amplifiers. They are practical circuits. You may have current amplifiers also using operational amplifier, but the circuits are going to be like this and they are not really very stable circuits. We don't use them. The only possibility is if you have very low current requirement in the load, then it's okay. If your load is of the order of 10 kilo ohms or 20 kilo ohms, then current will be in the milliamperes. 741 will be able to provide that much milliampere current definitely, and your circuits will sustain. But practically, current's requirements of current amplifier are more, and therefore we don't use these kind of circuits quite often. We'll come to the practical aspects very easily. These are some schematic circuits of transconductance and transresistance amplifiers. You'll be surprised to know that we are having a voltage to current amplifier here in two different ways. We can have singular voltage connected as input. The other voltage could be 0 volts. So, on left hand side, if you have a single voltage source present and the other terminal is grounded, then V1 minus V2 is taken as V1 only because V2 is 0 volts. That is possible. Or you may connect two different voltage sources. The effective input will be V1 minus V2. And load you are connecting, and this load you'll find that is having output voltage VO across it. We'll analyze these circuits separately. This is transresistance amplifier again, in which input is current and output is voltage. Again, it is not preferred. This is not usually preferred. Concluding, these are some typical parameters which we often refer to when we talk of operational amplifier, and these are some open loop characteristics. Just have a look at the slide. We'll explain this particular slide quite in detail next time. Right now, I want to continue ahead with respect to the previous slide only. Right? Let me come back to blackboard over here and explain two important parameters of operational amplifier for a few minutes more. Let us say I have this operational amplifier in which I have negative terminal here and positive terminal over here, and I am taking the output voltage. Let us say I have this amplifier as ideal amplifier. Since ideal amplifier, I have differential gain as infinity. I have CMRR as equal to infinity. I also have input impedance as equal to infinity, and I do have output impedance as equal to 0 ohms. Ideal operational amplifier. When I am considering this as ideal amplifier, let us have a look at the impedance over here is Ri, and if I connect some voltage source V1 here with respect to ground, what will happen? This voltage source is available to this point with respect to ground. The voltage of a point here is V1, and how much will be the current flowing in as I1? I1 will be given by V1 divided by Ri. This point, for the time being, I am grounding. Apply KVL in this loop. If I apply KVL in this loop, then I will have equation, which is a very straightforward and simple equation, given as I1 as equal to V1 divided by Ri. Isn't it? Now, since Ri is infinity, I will replace this Ri for ideal operational amplifier, infinity. If I do so, what will be the value of I1? I1 will be equal to 0. No current is drawn. Since there is no current drawn, drop across this R1 will be V1 only. Means this particular point voltage and this particular point voltage is one and the same. Since this particular point voltage and this particular point voltage is same, I can consider this as a virtual ground. I can consider this as a virtual ground. Why is it a virtual ground? Because I am not directly connecting it to ground. But it appears that it is connected to a virtual ground. Let me take another practical example. Let us say, I have some resistance R over here. Let me analyze a Kirchhoff voltage loop over here. And if I do so, I'll get something like this. Current again, let us assume current flowing is I. So, I will have V1 is equal to I into R plus I into Ri. That means it is equal to I bracket R plus Ri. And this gives me I as equal to V1 upon R plus Ri. Is it? If I have this equation from my Kirchhoff voltage law, then I comes out as equal to V1 upon R plus Ri. Ri is infinity. Since Ri is infinity, this value will be equal to 0. Now, since this particular value is 0, what will be the potential of this particular point x? Vx therefore is equal to current flowing through as I into Ri. I is 0 multiplied by Ri comes out as 0 volts. So this point voltage is 0. What is the voltage of this point? 0. Why it is 0? Because it is connected to ground. Since this point voltage is 0, since it is connected to ground, and this point is also having a voltage as 0, I can call this point as a virtual ground. And therefore, potential drop available across this R will be equal to V1 only straight away. So what sort of voltage you are applying at the input is appearing across this R. And this point is coming up as a virtual ground. Now I am measuring the output voltage over here with respect to ground. I am connecting, say, RL load over here. Since it is connected to ground, and the other terminal of RL will be at 0 volt. This terminal will be at voltage VO. I can assume that instead of RL connected this way, if I connect RL here back to this particular point, which is a virtual ground, no problem. I have to connect output with respect to ground. This point is a virtual ground. I can very well connect this RL between these two terminals without violating KVL. And if I do so, I get what is called as inverting amplifier. I am getting inverting amplifier, and formula for this will be very, very simple to calculate. Let us see. V1 is the voltage appearing across R. VO is the output voltage with respect to ground, which is a voltage across this RL. So, VO is equal to IO into RL divided by VO into RL, and VI as equal to R into I. Therefore, amplification factor AD will be given by VO upon VI, which is equal to IO into RL upon I into R. Right? Now, apply Kirchhoff current law to this particular point. The current is flowing over here, and this current is IO, this current is I. Apply KCL to this particular point, and what do you get? I as equal to minus IO. That's all. Because the current flowing inside is practically zero. Why this current is zero? Because RI is infinity. Very large value. Since it is infinity, no current will flow. And if you apply KCL current loop, current law, Kirchhoff law, to this particular point, you will find that I is equal to minus IO. So, in this formula, I will replace this I as minus IO. What do I get? This is equal to minus of RL upon R. If I name this R as R1, then it becomes RL upon R1. This is a closed loop voltage amplifier in which amplification factor for the complete circuit will be defined by ratio of resistance that you are connecting here with respect to the resistance that you have connected at the input side. RL upon R1 will be the formula, and this is the circuit of inverting amplifier. Why is it inverting? Because you are getting a negative sign here. If you are not getting a negative sign here, it would have been non-inverting amplifier. Since A is negative, since the voltage gain of this circuit is negative, you have inverting amplifier with you. And this is a typical circuit of operational amplifier. The value of RL and R1 could be so chosen that we can have desired amplification factor for this particular circuit very easily. I think I'll stop here and continue next time for another circuits of operational amplifier from here onwards. I, however, want to emphasize that this point is called as a virtual ground in this circuit. Why? You should know about it. You should understand why this point is a virtual ground. Since RI is infinity, no potential drop across this RI, the potential of this point is zero, so potential of this point will also be zero. And since this particular potential difference is zero, no current will be drawn. It can be considered as a virtual ground. And this virtual ground is a specific case for operational amplifier. And this helps us in designing variety of circuits out of operational amplifier, which we will see from next time onwards. Thank you very much. I'm closing here. Thank you.